السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، أهلا وسهلا بكم أعزائنا طلبة الدراسات العليا في فرع التعويضات الاصطناعية وتكملة سلسلة محاضرات الجيراتريك دينتزري. Our lecture today titled Medical Conditions and Related Medication in Geriatric Patients. طبعا هو الشابتر الرابع عنوانه Sensory Changes and Communications in the Practitioner-Aged Patient Relationship. The importance of dental communication. Effective communication of dental professional can prevent errors in the patient comprehension of home care and future dental needs. Also, to meet the needs of growing older population, dental professionals are increasingly aware of the importance of establishing relationship with patient and understanding what motivates them to maintain good home care. To seek regular preventive appointment and can establish link with the patient and to avoid emergency visits to the dental office. Sensory changes with aging. Normal aging may affect memory and learning skills, which can compound the impact of declining vision and hearing. The rate of decline varies among the senses and among individuals. For example, visual accommodation declines from most people after age of 45 years, whereas the olfactory function is often maintained in the 72nd. Because these changes are gradual and we adapt to compensatory mechanism as each sensory mode declines. Sensory changes with function, with aging, sorry, change in the visual function, changes in the auditory functions and memory and learning in old age. Changes in visual function. Changes in the visual pathways of the brain and the visual cortex may be responsible for the observed age-related decline in visual sensation and perception. These changes are attributed to the structural change in the cornea, lens, rods and cones in the retina. Many adults start using prescription lenses for the first time at age of 45 to 55, specifically for reading and close-up work. Others must adjust to new forms of transition lenses. There are an even refraction of the light that reaches the lens. This results in serious problems, especially the sitting with an uneven distribution of light, for example, dental light or a large window facing the dental chair. Another age-related changes in the lens that affect the visual functions are increased opacity. The lenses of the young child's eyes are quite transparent. With aging, they become more opaque so that less light reaches the retina. In extreme case, one of both lenses may become opaque that not light can reach to the retina, reducing the condition of cataracts, which leads to the blindness. Also, the color depth and distance perception also deteriorate with aging. Older adults have more difficulty with color recognition, particularly in the blue-green end of the color spectrum. These two colors tend to fade and become difficulty of adaptation from light to dark. This is due to the diminished supply of oxygen to the retina and the slower shift from rods to cones. Therefore, older people require more time to adjust from brightly light setting to a dimly light one, such as entering a dental office directly from the outside. Also, macular degeneration, glaucoma, and cataracts. These conditions can significantly impair the older person's ability to accomplish activities of daily living, lead to increase the risk of falls and fractures and ulceration of older person. Changes in the auditory function. Hearing is vital for communication because hearing is closely associated with the speech. It loss disrupts a person's understanding of others and even recognition of one's own speech. Another person with hearing loss needs learns to make changes in the behavior and social interactions, unlike younger person who are hearing impaired from birth or early childhood. another person who gradually lost hearing acquired in late life rarely learns sign language to compensate for this loss. The most common cause of auditory deficiencies in the older age is the progressive bilateral sensorineural loss of the ability to hear high frequency from 300 to 2000 Hz and low volume sound, a language which can deteriorate more rapidly in one eye than other. Hearing loss generally occurs in both ears at the same time, but not necessarily to the same extent. In particular, they might have difficulty in distinguishing among the higher frequency consonant phonemes such as S, F, SH, T, TH, K, and P. Tinnitus is another problem that can impair hearing in old age. This is a high pitched ring in one or both ears that is particularly acute at night or in quiet surroundings. The incidence often increases from 3% for young adults to 9% for the middle-aged people and to 11% among this age. 65 to 74 individuals who have been exposed to high volume and high frequency noise throughout their lives are at a greater risk than those from rural low noise environments. People suffering from tinnitus can generally learn to manage it by altering treatments such as acupuncture. Memory and hearing in older age. These are two cognitive processes that must be considered together. That is, learning is assumed to have occurred when an individual is able to accurately recover information from his or her memory store. Thus, learning is the process by which new information, verbal or non-verbal, or skills are encoded or put into one's memory. Memory is the process of recalling the information that was stored in the past. Several types of memory have been identified: primary, short-term or working memories, and secondary, long-term memories. Primary memory is the temporary stage of holding, processing, or organizing information such as phone number or someone name. We use that name or number immediately, then forget it. In fact, most adults can recall 7 + 2 pieces of information for 60 seconds or less. Secondary memory is the part of our memory that stores where we retain everything we have learned throughout our lives. Unlike primary memory, it has unlimited capacity. Compensating for visual and auditory decline. For the dental practitioner, following recommendations are prepared to aid in the reception of communication by the aged patient. When written materials are prepared for other patients, for example, home care instructions and appointment calendar, recommended treatment, use bold, large print, and computer graphic program. This is a simple but effective way to assist the older person's visual function. Use of contrasting color for written messages. The use of blue, green, purple together in any printed material should be avoided. Also, when speaking with older patients, one can aid their use of compensatory mechanism by facing the patient directly and maintaining eye contact, for example, mouth and lip formation when pronounced late and left words are different from persons who are learning impaired, and that visual sign may be all the patient need to make the distinction. Also, standing closer to older patients may also aid the reception of information through the auditory and visual channels. However, the dental professional must be sensitive to cultural differences because some older patients may react negatively to the invasion of their personal space. Also, the pattern of volume of speech should also be considered. Thus, it will aid in the older person comprehension comprehension of dental professionals speak more slowly and clearly, but without exaggerating sound. Raising one's voice slightly may be helpful. Finally, speak with older patients and their caregivers or family members in a quiet environment. The private office is the better setting in which to discuss the patient's health history and dental complaints. The private office generally has less background noise, fewer distracting conversations that can divert patient attention, and allow greater privacy for older patients to express their thoughts in confidence. Compensating for cognitive decline. Older patients should be fully informed about the proposed treatment plan. However, based on the description of age-related cognitive changes, the dental team may benefit from some of the recommendations listed below. This can help reduce potential problems of the patient dissatisfaction, non-compliance, and failure due to the misunderstandings between the dental team and older patients. First, discuss examinations, findings, and treatment recommendations in a quiet, relaxed setting with no background noise. Structure the message to that it is presented in a step-by-step manner. This oral information should be accompanied by the brief typed form that provided the same information and a calendar with appointment dates and time marked. Take more time to list the complaints or concerns of older patients to discuss dental procedure. Repeat the message and permit the patient to ask questions at each step. Unfortunately, it's rarely used in the clinical setting. Do not present too much information at once in an attempt to reduce information overload. Dental and home care instruction must avoid the tendency to go the one visit. Family members and caregivers can also be given this information to assist the older patient with newly acquired oral health information. Finally, use multiple modes of communication. Information present in a written format and reviewed orally. This is, the patient is retained longer than either taking to patients or giving them a written message to read when you get home. Age-related changes in oral sensory functions. Normal age-related changes in oral sensory functions include taste, smell, and proprioception. Men influence older adults' ability to taste, smell, and enjoy foods. Although age-related sensory changes are gradual, continual dissatisfaction with the smell and taste of food may result in malnutrition among older who no longer enjoy eating and therefore reduce their dietary intake. Aging does not result in significant loss of taste buds or in the number of papillae on the tongue, but mostly attributable to some systemic disease and many of the medications used to treat them. The problem is aggravated by the reduction of saliva, also caused by some medications and radiation for head and neck cancers. Saliva play a critical role in taste by making food more soluble and carrying the taste stimulus to the taste buds. Reduced salivary flow can also impair taste function. Older adults have more difficulty than younger people to discriminating between varying intensities of flavor. Appreciation of food doesn't depend on the taste alone. The sense of smell clearly is involved. Older adults with proprioceptor decline may lack the ability to sense the movement of their tongue and thus have difficulty controlling its movement. They may also have problems sensing the location of their limbs. These problems can be obstacle to home care and dental procedure, especially with impaired balance. This is an important consideration when older patients are transferring in and out of dental chairs, or even when the chair is being tilted into different positions. Now we go to pharmacology and aging, chapter 12. As the population ages, the number of patients with chronic diseases who take multiple medications, polypharmacy increase. The presence of these diseases and the drugs used to treat them make managing this patient in the dental office increasingly complex. There are six issues to consider when managing and prescribing for older patients taking medications. Medication as an indicator of medical conditions, current medical conditions and medication as they affect dental care, oral side effect of medications, pharmacodynamics as the effect of dental management, current medical conditions and medication as they affect dental prescribing, also non-compliance to medication use. Medication as an indicator of medical conditions. Steps for reviewing the existing medication list. Number one, could any of these drugs be required during the medical emergency? Like use of nitroglycerin for angina. Two, why is the patient taking this particular medication? Group by categories to aid in assessing overall risk in patient care and management. That anticoagulant drug, immunosuppression, and antidepressant drug. Three, do any drugs have the potential to contribute to complication or even create an emergency situation, like warfarin, lead to excessive bleeding, prednisolone for adrenal insufficiency? Also, do any of these drugs have potential oral side effects, like for antihistamine that cause xerostomia? Oral side effect of medications. Many drugs have the adverse intraoral side effect. The drugs with the potential for these side effects should be identified. For example, diuretics and antidepressant drugs often contribute to salivary hypofunction and xerostomia, while calcium channel blockers and some immunosuppressant drugs can cause gingival hyperplasia. The dentist should consider consulting with the patient physician about changing one xerostomic medication to another with similar indication but fewer side effects. Medical conditions and medications as they impact dental prescribing. The patient's current list of medications may alter the dentist's prescribing patterns for pharmacokinetical use today in the dental practice. Drug classes commonly used in general dentistry include analgesics, antibiotics, antifungals, antivirals, anesthetics, vasoconstrictors, and sedatives. There are generally 3 to 5 commonly used medications in each class. However, most practitioners limit their prescribing pattern to 1 or 2 in each class. Salivary function and disorder in the older adults. Formation of saliva. Three major primary salivary glands. We have parotid, submandibular, and sublingual secrete a complex protein-rich saliva. Water transport from the serum with organic and inorganic components. The saliva is modified as it is carried by the branching duct system into the oral cavity. The secretion of saliva is controlled by sympathetic and parasympathetic neural input. Fluid secretion stimulation is primarily by muscarinic cholinergic receptors, while the stimulus for protein release occurs largely through beta adrenergic receptors. Many drugs taken by older adults have anti-muscarinic and anti-adrenergic side effects. Salivary gland function with aging. It was previously thought that the salivary input diminished with the increasing age. This was based on the clinical observation that older individuals frequently have a dry mouth and complain of xerostomia. However, investigations reveals that there is no substantial reduction in salivary production across the human lifespan in healthy adults. Thus, in the absence of complicating factors like certain systemic diseases or medications, there is no generalized age-related disruption in the production of salivary fluid. Common medication associated with the salivary hypofunction include anticholinergics, antihistamines, antihypertensive drugs, anti-Parkinson's disease, cytotoxic agents, sedatives, and tranquilizers, skeletal muscle relaxants, and tricyclic antidepressants. Symptoms of xerostomia: decreased fluid in the oral cavity, dryness of all oral pharyngeal mucosal surface, including the lips and the throat, difficulty of chewing, swallowing, tasting, and speaking, also sensitive to spicy or coarse food, which limits the patient's enjoyment of meals. In this picture, we can see the buccal mucosa may be pale and corrugated in the appearance due to the diminish of salivary excretion in the oral cavity. Also, the tongue may be smooth and erythematic with the evidence of depopulation. There is often a marked increase in the erosion and caries, particularly decay or rose surfaces, due to the reduction in the cleaning ability of salivary flow in the oral cavity. Enlargement of the salivary gland can be visualized, requiring distinction between inflammatory infections, inflammatory, infectious, or neoplastic etiologies. The major salivary glands should be palpated to detect masses and also to determine if salivary can be expressed by the main excretory ducts. Enlarged glands that are painful in palpation are indicated of infection or acute inflammation. If distinct masses within the body of the major salivary gland are palpated, an obstruction, benign or malignant tumor should be considered. Treatment strategies. There are 5 categories of treatment strategies for the older patient with salivary hypofunction. Also include preventive therapy, symptomatic or sedative treatment, local or topical salivary stimulation, also systemic salivary stimulation, and therapy. In general, the overall strategy should include a combination of supplemental fluoride for dentate individuals, also topical sedative, symptomatic treatment, water. As the most available symptomatic treatment, water will help moisten the oral cavity, hydrate the mucosa, and clear food debris. It also improves the mastication, swallowing, and taste. Dental individuals should avoid the regular use of sugar-free carbonate drinks, as the acidic content of this product is high and may increase tooth demineralization. Oral rinses, mouthwashes, gels, and products containing aloe vera or vitamin E are available for dry mouth patients and can help reduce symptoms of dry mouth. Many commercially available salivary substitutes or artificial saliva, they come in many different formulations, rinses, spray, foams. However, they are not well accepted by long-term use. Go to chapter 21, artificial pain in older adults. Age-related neuronal changes may contribute to alterations in pain sensation in older adults. Evidence suggests that there is loss of and myelinated and myelinated peripheral and central nerve fibers, with a reduction of about 50% of unmyelinated fibers compared with 35% loss of myelinated efferent fibers. These age-related findings may reflect the decrease in peripheral nerve fibers of all types, motor, sensory, and sympathetic, contributing to a decrease in pain transmission from efferent peripheral nerves. The prevalence of orofacial pain appears to progressively decrease with age. About 40% in the general population, orofacial pain is reported in one quarter of these aged 65 to 75 years, and 17% of those aged older than 75 years. The most commonly reported orofacial pain in older adults are oral sores, followed by toothache, jaw joint pain, face pain, and burning mouth. Also, older females reported a higher prevalence of jaw joint pain and facial pain than males. Non-odontogenic pain conditions often require referral to pain specialists. Temporal mandibular joint are conditions affecting the TM joint and the muscles of mastication. The clinical signs and symptoms of TMD can be classified as muscular disorders, internal derangement of the TM joint, clicking, locking, and the degenerative changes to the bony component of the joints. Treatment always begin with conservative modalities, including patient education, reducing stressful jaw function, also eliminating aggravating factors, and physical therapy. Short-term use of non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs may also be beneficial in older adults. Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disease of the synovial membrane, characterized by formation of granulation tissue at the articular surfaces and the erosion of underlying bone. Rheumatoid arthritis has a peak incidence between the age of 40 to 60 years, and women are affected more than men. If the temporomandibular joints are affected, involvement is usual bilateral, during acute rheumatoid arthritis affecting the TM joints. Conservative treatment and anti-inflammatory medications are recommended in coordination with the patient rheumatologist. Trigeminopathy is a neuropathic pain syndrome that affects approximately 5% from 100,000 population, occurring more often in women, and the incidence gradually increases with age, beginning around 40 years old. However, in patients older than 80 years, males have a higher incidence. This condition is characterized by sudden, sharp, severe unilateral pain. It is often described as geriatric shooting and burning, which follows one or more branches of the trigeminal nerve. Typically, the maxillary or mandibular branch affected. The sensation can last seconds to minutes, then disappearing, leaving pain-free intervals between attacks. Pain management for the older patient. In older adults, a multimodal approach to pain management is suggested, using pharmacological therapy, non-pharmacological modalities like education, exercise, weight loss, physical therapy, closure appliances, and psychosocial supports to maximize the older adult's function and the quality of life. Poor pain control can significantly increase morbidity and mortality, and has also been linked to sleep disturbances, functional disabilities, and depression. We go to chapter 23, which is concerned about oral health related quality of life. What's the quality of life? In recent literature, quality of life has become widely separate term. It means different things to different authors. In an effort to focus on the assessment of health and the quality of life issues, the term health related quality of life is now widely used. Other terms used include subjective health status and functional status. There is a complex relationship between health, disease, and quality of life, and the nature of interrelationships are not clearly defined. Dimension of quality of life, or multidimensional constructs. physical function, mobility, self-care, emotional functions, depression and anxiety, social functions, intimacy, social contact, role performance like work, pain, other symptoms like fatigue and nausea. Chapter 26, clinical management of conjunctively impaired older adults and terminally ill older. Intervention for the prevention of behavioral problems. Most behavioral problems can be prevented by focusing on four main non-pharmacological interventions: decrease environmental stresses, meeting primary self needs, increasing quality and quantity of social interactions, balancing inner retreat time with the active time. What's the palliative oral care? It has been defined as the study and management of patients with active progressive far advanced disease, in whom the oral cavity can be compromised either by disease directly or by its treatment. The goal of palliative care is the achievement of optimum quality of life for terminally ill patients and their families. The palliative care team consists of physicians, nurses, social workers, psychologists, dietitians, and dentists. Dentists be able to openly talk about dying with the patient and their families and discuss issues such as fear, progressive pain, and discomfort, financial hardship, and feelings of being a burden on others. This is the end of our lecture. Thank you very much for your listening.